So, at Truckfest now you can hear, but something happened, didn't it, Churi?
Yeah, you've been wrong.
This morning. So I'm going to allow him to switch over to his phone to show what actually happened. So, as you can see, the top corner is cracked. Right here, and right there. I've ended up cracking my phone to the point where the screen's hanging off. And yes, I'm having to use my brother's case. I think the screen needs gluing down. I'm not too bothered about the cracks. The big crack there is a bit of a problem, but oh well. It's a case of I'm gonna have to deal with it till I get it fixed.
Yeah, I'm pretty freaked out. When the color's off, nothing's on the other. Red one's next. Five. Three times. That's that roll, Barry. know that for a fact. I'm not going, man. Thank you. Views, which back then it was when I was first started, that was mental. And then, like, I just kept doing funny videos and trying to think of new things I could do. So I put a bath in my truck, a sink, a shower on the outside with a shower curtain and everything. Had a shower in a lay-by. Just a crazy things, really.
I bet you got truck. Some very funny looks along the way.
Yeah, I did. Yeah, some of the lorry drivers that were parked behind me gave me a few funny looks. Yeah, but it's worth it for the content. And those videos went viral, basically, and that is where my following started.
Did you think when you sat back and you went, "I'm going to make a TikTok page for a bit of a laugh and do a bit of fun"? Did you think it was going to get to where it is now? Here we are, like 3-4 years on.
Yeah. So yeah, it's been about 2.5, nearly 3 years. I didn't expect to think that basically TikTok and YouTube would actually be my career now in 2 years. I didn't expect that. I just did it for just something to do whilst out on the road when it's like boring.
So where did YouTube? Because you say you started off with TikTok. Where did YouTube come in? How did that come about?
Yeah, so TikTok came about. Well, basically, I got my followers to thank from TikTok, really, because they said you should start a YouTube channel, Tim. That'd be awesome. Like, get some longer videos on, because back then you could only do 60 seconds on TikTok, and they wanted to see like longer videos. So I set up a YouTube channel and said, you know, if I get 1,000 subscribers, I'll post my first video.
And then, how long did you have to wait?
Yeah, not long, like literally overnight. So, and then I had to think, right, I've got to put a nice R-Series there. Like that. Look at that.
You should
So I got distracted then, there's a truck going by. Where were we? Sorry, look at
you were talking about you're building a YouTube page.
Yeah, basically built a YouTube page. I just started doing videos of me driving a truck, doing like my daily job, basically. And that went, they just started snowballing then. I remember the first video that went sort of viral on YouTube was me having a night out in the truck at Newcastle. And like literally that got like 1 million views on YouTube, which is crazy from on YouTube, that's like ridiculous. And I got loads of followers from that video as well. And then since then it's just carried on skyrocketing.
Now you're about to hit a milestone as far as followers goes on YouTube. How far are we off?
Well, I'm 169,000 subscribers on YouTube and 2,000, I think it's actually since yesterday, it was 2,000 away from 1 million on TikTok. I think it's 1,800 away from 1 million
now. So you've got 200 followers just
yesterday.
That's just crazy. If anybody wants to follow Tim, by the way, it's really simple. We go onto TikTok or YouTube or Instagram. What do we type
in? And just Trucker Tim, basically, on there. Yeah, you find me, even if you just go on YouTube, on Google, sorry, and put in Trucker Tim, I'm just there at the top. You can see all my channels there. So
what's it like to be right at the top? That's that must be a bit weird, isn't
it? Yeah, it is a bit weird, yeah. But it's lovely being here today and seeing all my followers and fans as well. Meeting everybody, seeing the actual faces behind the numbers on the screen that I see.
Now, we did speak about a year and a half ago. We spoke at the Malvern show. I think this is when we first started chatting and doing this. And you spoke about this truck you were building and you were going to get it ready for 2023. It was going to be there at the beginning of the season.
Yeah.
We didn't see it. It was going to be there later in the season. We still haven't seen. Where is it?
No, well, it's in my unit.
Okay.
In basically just down to chassis bales. Sorry. Yeah, just bare chassis bales.
So there's nothing really
on it. It's just literally a chassis. Everything stripped off it and going to restore it. So basically when I bought the truck I wasn't going to go as deep as I did, like as I have done. I was literally just going to just give it a strip down, a quick shot blast, leave the engine in, leave the cab on. But the more I've gone into it, I think you've got to do it properly. So I've now took the engine out, I've took the cab off and got in all the chassis properly, got all the rust off and everything. And I'm actually doing like a proper full restoration now. So yeah, it's gone a bit deeper than I thought it was.
So will it be ready for 2024?
Oh, I don't know. Late 24. Probably, it might nearly be ready for Newark next year.
Really on the end there too. That was incredible.
this time. Are you ready for a fest? Here we go then. Count with me in 3, 2, 1, go!
been on, this is the one that's thrown me around more.
Seen the show as before, we're going to take them on the small bit, land on the big bit, we're going to do all sorts of aerobatical maneuvers, we're going to take off the small, like I was saying before, we're going to go 35 feet up in the air, 75 feet in distance, hopefully going to do all sorts of aerobatical in the face. We're going to see how long we can get it going for. The mud seems to be dragging up the takeoff, it makes it quite slippy, seeing as all the trucks have been driving around. Made it quite muddy in here. Hopefully we will be okay. So, just gonna have a little tester, make sure these bikes are nice and warm. Once we've had the tester, we're gonna stop, have a little intro to both myself and Josh, anybody that didn't see us before. After that, once we've done the intro, we are then gonna start with some easy tricks. After the easy tricks, gonna move on to a few harder tricks. And then hopefully after that, we're gonna have a little competition. So, perfect one there from Josh. See what we've got. Well, I'm very slippy on the grass. Absolutely perfect. Pendulum there, kicking the feet either side of the bike. Josh on his way in now, what's Josh got? That's a no footer there from Josh, slipping around a little bit, getting a bit slippy, dragging that dirt up those takeoff. Well, we can't make it allow for the English weather. That's a little no hander there, letting go to the park, so I was flying 30 feet up in the air. Nothing there from Josh. Nice and steady. Flying all that way up in the air. Wow. Little knack-knack there. Trying to land as straight as possible in this rain. Josh coming in big. Real tricky there. Landing right at the bottom there from Josh. Just spinning up a little bit. So was that any good? Go back to the show. So, let's see what we can do. Try and go a little bit bigger and better out there. Spinning up a little bit on the way up, just coming a little bit short there. Not what we're after. Josh having a go. Big switchblade there from Josh. Making that one look easy. So, blippy. Little Superman there, off the back of the bike. Just being quick with this one. Josh on his way now. Oh, now nice little switchblade there from Josh. Got one of these more, one more in. Switchblade there, kicking back, looking back on yourself. I'm going to have to pull in, trying to clean my goggles. Josh, you're going to come and do one more. No little pendulum now. Let's see what we do. Oh, just slipping around. Might have to have another little go at that one. Not what we're after there. Feels horrible. Oh, slipping around again. Terrible knack-knack. Wow, struggling there, really struggling. Not what we wanted. No rain in your face, just not what you want to be doing. Trying to make sure you get over and over the jump. So, Josh on his way in there. Oh, switch plane safe again. So, I can going round again, getting scared. Really struggling. Oh, terrible one again. Got it, spooked himself out. Scared in this rain, Josh. I think you've got, well, obviously you've got it. All you've got to do is go over and wave, haven't you? He's upset. He's doing terrible. He's very upset. It's very slippery. Yeah, you're right. Just what you want to be doing. Slipping just as you're about to hit that jump. So, rain going in your face. Josh has got an easy win here. I think he doesn't have to do anything, does he? Big tsunami there from Josh, making it. Keep your eye in the middle of the arena, see what we can do for you now in this wet and rainy conditions. So we've been broken for next. Thank you very much.
Coming into you!
see what he's got. Look at the mud on the windscreen. Now remember, he's got no window wipers. He's jumping blind. Let's see what he can do. I'm going right back. Right, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Are you ready? It's 3, 2, 1, go! Tony's gone way back. All right, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? In 3, 2, 1, go! How awesome was that? Right, here comes Alan then. Final jump then from Alan Bourne, local boy from just 3 miles down the road. Here he is on his home turf. Final jump for Truckfest 2023. What's he gonna do? I can tell you he's gone way back. Here it comes. This is the big one. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? In 3, 2, 1, go! Awesome! So that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed Truckfest Newark, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.